out to others, and you've caused them to subscribe and to our YouTube, even to follow us through Facebook, and this is very encouraging. May God bless so much. We have Apostolic Faith Church, and also Bishop Peter Katimbo. It's powerful. We are reaching out to you now from Apostolic Faith Church, Bahati, Nairobi. We love you. The Lord bless and keep you. Now, today I want to share on a short teaching on put off the weight. Put off the weight. We are living at a times where we are encountering a heaviness. Not physical. No. But something that is that has no name. But just a kind of heaviness in mind, in feelings, in your attitude, that you know very well you are supposed to be somewhere, but you eventually not get there on time. You know at this season you are supposed to be reasoning this way, and you are supposed to have attained this, but you are not able to do it. And now part of deliverance that I need and you need is deliverance from a strange heaviness. Sometimes you cannot even call it demon. You can't call it a disease. You don't have a name for it. Why? Because Satan uses deception. Satan uses deception. Satan uses confusion. Satan uses fear. You need to note the three: confusion, deception, and fear. Actually, number one weapon of the devil is deception. Before other things come, there are those three aspects of the evil one that comes first to give room to the real attack: deception, fear, and confusion. And because majority of us have no capacity to articulate, majority, we have lost power of concentration. I've been handling cases of youth. Some come with their parents, some come alone, because our church is open to mentorship. We've reached out with the heart of mentorship. And so they come, and they're open. They can tell me anything. Bishop, this what happened to me. And majority of the youth, because of the drugs, parents are complaining. They are unable to concentrate. They are unable to be consistent. They are unable to connect. Actually, drugs destroys that capacity in a man that makes you human. That capacity in you that carries your gift. That capacity in a person that help you to concentrate until you finish. Most people who are used to drugs, they don't finish. They are not so much. And the real test of life, family life, education for children, good marriage, ability to put up structures and raise family businesses, they don't have that taste. They don't have. And that's what we are saying. We need to put off some weight. There's a weight that is coming around us. In the Bible, Hebrews chapter 12 talks about weight that we should put off. Some kind of weight. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12, I hope you have a Bible. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a crowd of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Now, what the areas that we need to put off? One part of weight that we are undergoing. Of course, I've just mentioned the deception, there, fear, and I've talked about confusion, which is not part of you, and which sometimes, even if we apply a lot of counseling, psychological counseling, it never ends. It has to end with transformation. It has to end up with a volitional commitment to change. It has to do with the God we serve. Now, one of the things we need to put off is areas of attack in life. Areas of attack in life and in families. One, sometimes the devil will attack a very close relative, a son or daughter, that you can't avoid. It's so hard for a father. It's so hard for a father or mother to avoid son or daughter. The link, the yoke is so much powerful that your son, when you raise a son, when you raise a daughter, it gives you at least contentment. It causes you to feel part of the main purpose of living, the main purpose of why you wake up in the morning and work so hard, has been accomplished by you personally raising a responsible and talented daughter or son. But now that area is being attacked, being infected, is the area where the evil one has released a lot of weapons through feelings, through social entanglement, through deception. You realize that your son is as if he's not your son. He has another area. He has another center of life, center of power, center of influence, center of meaning outside you. You are the person who gave birth to that person, to the son or daughter. But as she grew up, acquired other way of living, which is contrary to you, and your son or daughter is as if he is being raised to be an enemy to you and your norms, to you and the values, family values, and it really affect you. Now, another thing, we'll come to the answers later. Another thing that is weight is a lack, a persistent lack. A persistent lack. Either lack of peace, lack of money, lack of resources, but lack that is so persistent. So persistent, so stubborn. So stubborn. Until some people say, now pray for me, I don't know. Somehow come here and say, no, Bishop, I used to own this property. I used to own this shop. I used to own this godown. I used to own a fleet of vehicles. And I have sold all of them to clear debt. And the more I do it, the more the debt increases. And I have had those people who have been millionaires. And say, now, you know, we used to be millionaires, but now we are begging. And you end up in a demonic lack that is so persistent. And you don't know what to do because a demon came in and made a stronghold around your resources. And we need to address that now. And by the power of the blood of Christ, we are going to release you from that heaviness. Today we will pray for you. In Jesus, there are two things that are not able to be solved psychologically. Sin and demonic presence. Sin. You see, we need to handle that. Another thing that is an area of attack is an agent of Satan. An individual or a spirit. Because people are so psychological, the issue of that an individual can be used by Satan or a demon can be sent to torture your family, the fact, the issue about spirits, demons that need to be cast out, that need to be overcome, in most people is not rising. It's not that the issue of spirits never service, never has a meaning. And the issue, and we want to tell you, friends, the issue that Satan can attack you, the issue that Satan has spirits or agents that he uses to destroy people or to kill or to cause pain, this must be accepted. And we accept also that Jesus was revealed to destroy Satan and his works. We must admit that two things. Satan exists. His spirits exist. His works exist. But Christ was revealed to destroy the works of the devil. That one must be admitted. And another thing that brings weight these days is a habit in you. A habit in you. A habit. Or a person closer to you. Let's talk about a habit. There are times you form a habit. When somebody is, I'm not saying that you are ignorant, or maybe you could be ignorant, but sometimes you live in a way that you are open. You are open. You are so loose. You are open to anything. And when people are so loose, so passive, not active, you are so passive, so loose, you don't care so much. You don't care so much. You are not sensitive. There are times you can develop a habit that you later become a stronghold, a pillar in your life, which will be a problem. And therefore, I would advise you and advise us, all of us, that we never be loose. Let us be awake and strict so that there will be no room, there will be no space, there will be no opening for such attack, whereby you realize that you are open to attack or you are open to some thoughts. Because we say any habit starts with thoughts. We say mind your thoughts. They might turn to be actions. Mind your actions. They are likely to turn around to be habits. Mind your habits. They might turn around to be, to constitute your main character. And therefore, it is started like thought that comes into my life or your life. You're not careful. You are just open. You are so loose. And they get deeper. They get deeper, deeper, deeper until the thought drives you to action. And then you are so loose. You are not sensitive to God. You are not sensitive to goodness, future. It ends up becoming a habit. And if you continue that way, you become a slave to several habits that you are unable to change. You are unable to change. And you end up in the results of those habits, whereby life, you know, life is a matter of time and space. So when you have habits that are bad and that are evil, that control you, you realize that you spend more time in those habits and you end up growing old, losing the seasons that would have been profitable, wasting years and seasons and moments that required serious attention. And therefore, we are saying, kindly, in the name of Jesus, before habits become the key fiber, the key pillars of your character, watch out those habits. We need to put down, we need to lay off weight of evil habits. Weight of evil habits that are destroying us. Another thing that we need to put off is a kind of persistent failure. Strange failure. Somebody, you open a shop, it falls, it fails. You start a move, you never materialize. You know, a persistent failure. And sometimes we continue on failing, without improving. There are times we say you need to do what we call an introspective view. Ask yourself, why am I failing? What could be the cause? Where? Am I not active? It's like this. If you go to a doctor, a good doctor, a good consultant, you have this disease, sickness. A doctor will place you under examination to determine what is the cause. Because the problem is not just the disease. It's the issue of the bacteria, the virus, or maybe the attack that has caused the disease. And therefore, good doctors will investigate the cause. Instead of persistent failure, why don't you stop a little bit and identify the cause? And I tell the truth, one of the aspects of our ministry in the church is receiving those people who have failed, receiving those people who have failed. And we sit down and discern the areas of weakness, and we build them again, and they become successful and talented. We preach every Sunday, no one should be poor. No one should be poor. In fact, the Bible says, let the weak say he is strong. Let the poor say he is rich. God wants to raise us to a standard. We can't come to God's presence being poor and remain poor. No, God has a formula. No child, any boy, any youth in the church, we tell them, no one here is poor. No one is a fool. We are all performers. We just need to rise up, put off the weight. You know, I remember this case of a young man. In his last year in high school, the first semester, he came to me as a bishop, from form 2 to form 3. Because our system in Kenya, high school, you end up at form 4. And his middle year, form 2, form 3, he performed very poorly. He brought all the report forms. He had D minus, D, D plus, D, D. He said, Bishop, I've come to you believing what you preached. No one is full. No one should fail to perform. And the boy had a lot of faith. He waited for me in the office until it was late. And we joined hands and believed. And the boy changed his attitude and applied some more force into his studies. And eventually, in the final exam, he had almost to acquire a very good A. The parents could not understand. But God came in and removed, rid off the weight. It's possible that the original you are a great man. The original you are a great woman. The original you are a great youth. I said the original you are a performer. I command you by the grace of God, put off the weight. Put off the weight. The original you are great. God said to Jeremiah, I knew you before I formed you, and before you were born, I appointed you. I chose you. I sanctified you to be a prophet. God has done that to me and you. Lay off the weight, for in you are a performer, you are gifted and talented. I declare this by the authority of Christ, by whose name we were created. Now, there could be another weight that we need to put off, is a weakness that is building up. There are times you notice you are a good person, but there's a weakness that is building up, a weakness. We may not have time to handle that, but note it somewhere. A weakness building up. Gradually. You know, Satan may not attack you direct. These days, Satan is becoming more technical. He's not attacking people direct. He is attacking people through influence. You are still a good person. You are still born again. But there is a strange influence. You can't call it evil. You cannot call it satanic. But it's a strange influence, feelings. So we need to handle that. A weakness building up. You are draining some strength. You are ignoring some agreement that you made with God. You are not so strict these days. We need to be very careful. There are times we need to deal with a demonic presence. There are times when you realize it's like there is a demonic station somewhere in your family or in your life. You try your best, you reach a certain point, you never get through. Try another method, you reach there, never get through. You know, have you checked families that have a limitation at a certain place? Even the grandchildren. Have you checked families whereby the career in the main profession of that family is just one? No one gets better or beyond a certain profession, which is maybe relatively low. And sometimes, unless you detect that there is a place in your family that no one gets beyond there, no one, you know, and we need to, it's a station, it's not godly. But let me tell the truth, if you speak against it and tell God, we now agree that we are getting beyond that place. No one should fail. When we get that level, we are declaring we are getting through. No one will hinder us. And God will bless us. Sometimes a demonic presence can bring a scheme. A scheme is a trick or a strategy. A trick or a strategy. Or that's what the Bible says, put on the whole armor that you may overcome the tricks, the strategies of the devil. Bible talks about stronghold or curses that you found in a family or you found in a place, or maybe stronghold or curses that are building up. Stronghold or curses that you found, or they are building up now. You know, there are places, there are families that are very good. Yes, you're okay. But now, you yourself, the current living person, you are the one who is opening up to evil and building up a stronghold of the devil. It started with you. Your wickedness, immorality, persistent rebelliousness, self-worship. You are opening up to ground that can eventually bring a curse in the family. We need to check ourselves and put off that weight. God will help us by his grace. There are times you need to put off a human weakness, natural weakness that is in your life. Some of us, if you check through your life, you find that you have a natural weakness. The way you speak, the way you work, you realize you are naturally lazy. You are naturally reactive. You get angry very easily. You are natural, you give up so easily. You need to address that. It may appear to be not evil, but is a natural weakness, a natural impediment that eventually can bring problem. Or another one is lack of self-control. You need to put off a habit whereby we lack self-control. You know, you need to build strong self-control if you are going to be rich. You need to build strong self-control if you are going to proceed on pleasing the Lord. You need to build up self-control of your appetite, desires. Yes, because we have problems in our bodies. If you don't control yourself, you end up not walking in ways that you can prosper. You know, sometimes you give somebody 10,000 shillings. That money is enough to make you rich. But you don't have self-control. You just use it for food and for luxuries. But the same money, if you control yourself, deny yourself, can become a seed that will eventually raise you to a prospered, rich person. Self-control. Laziness. Put off laziness. Naturally, at such a time, I don't know what's happening. Naturally, we tend to be lazy. And what we call, sometimes people want to rest. I just want to rest. To rest. But I would say we need to put off laziness. laziness is very bad. Another thing is lack of initiative. You find that all through where others have initiated projects, others are able to discern areas of success. You are not able to do it. You are not able to do it. And I want to tell you the truth. The Lord who made, who created you, has created you with capacity to initiate great things. Initiate powerful projects. It may start from a small beginning, but it will later flourish. That's why if you combine good initiative and self-control, I tell you, you will be able to channel your energy, to channel your might, to channel your effort, and succeed very well. We need to overcome, to put down pride. Generally, we have pride. Don't deny that. Where do we have, where is the pride? It's because we all want to be pleased, and we all want to enjoy ourselves. We all want to be appreciated. We all want that self-praise. It's not bad, but if you push that to extreme, you end up in pride. There are times when pride is part of you. Naturally, you have inherited that from family line. You know, you are proud just as your dad, mother, your grandmother were. It's something in their blood, in your blood makeup. It's a character, it's inherited trait. So, pride is bad. Do you know you exist? During the COVID, people noticed you exist among people. And you get rich because people buy from you, buy goods from you. You are rich because in your transport company, you have people who can pay for transport. You are rich because you are able, if you, the airline, Kenya Airways, Emirates, is because there are passengers that pay for the ticket for you to get money. People realize that you cannot be independent. You live because other people are who are around you. The market for your goods exists among people. So sometimes people forget that you are rich, you are blessed by God because God uses people in your shop. God uses people in your business. God uses people. Any company in this world has money because people buy from that company. And therefore, part of pride is when people, when you feel like you don't like people, you don't like other people, but the truth is you need them. You need to lay aside issues, the loose areas of in your life, loose mouth, feelings. There are times you are so loose, so irregular. Another area we need to lay weight, we put off weight, is family. Is some, there are some family norms that are good and others that are not good. You exist in a family, there are things that that family need to lay off. There are some beliefs that we need to lay off. There are some practices we need to lay off. There are some altars we need to lay off. There are some patterns of doing things that we need to lay off. There are defeats that we need to overcome. There are curses we need to lay off. And there are confessions we need to lay off. You find that you go to a family, the way they speak, the way they speak, it creates an attitude. It creates a lifestyle we need to lay off. We need to lay off strange areas. There are strange areas that requires discernment. There are times you leave and don't go, God, give me discernment to understand this darkness, to see through this darkness. I need to lay off this kind of darkness. And one thing is that we need discernment. We need the voice of God so that sometimes God, when God speaks, we are able to know our purpose in life. It's good to be open to the voice of God. And friends, we need to have what we call spiritual exercises that will help us to be disciplined. Let me talk about, we need what we call word discipline, word of God discipline. You know, sometimes you can spend days and weeks without a systematic way of studying the voice of God, the Bible. You have to a discipline of studying the Word of God. We need to have prayer discipline. If you are going to lay aside weight, we need to have a prayer discipline that we honor. A program of prayer and fasting. A program of morning hours prayer. A program of prayer that we honor. We need to have faith that can reach out. You know, you can have faith in yourself, but the faith has no effect from outside. Outside you, faith never works. You have faith just for you, inside you. But it never affects the surrounding. It never affects your finances. It never affects your family. We need to have faith that can reach out. Faith that can cause changes from inside to outside. That is very, very important. And God, you help us. We need to pray until our minds are quickened. We remove the heaviness, because your mind is very important. If your mind is awake, healthy, performing, quickened, stable, informed, you will become productive. We need to lay aside things that affect our minds, that cause heaviness in our mind, that cause stagnation in our mind, that cause lack of concentration. Lay aside the drugs, lay aside strange things. Sometimes people have strange dreams, weird dreams. Rebuke them by the blood of Christ. Keep your mind healthy and covered. Even when you are asleep, let the blood of Christ cover you, so that even when you are asleep in bed, you are covered. You can't just dream anything. You can only operate in the will of God. I say to you, and I say to myself, lay aside weight. We are living at the times when we have strange fear and strange weight allowed our mind and our feelings, our attitude. That means we need to lay it aside so that we can concentrate, so that our gifts and talents can be clear, so that we can overcome, so that we can subdue life. We can take dominion. May God bless you. I declare the blood of Christ on us all to cleanse us, to remove all heaviness, to remove every form of oppression, and to destroy the fear, to destroy the confusion, to destroy every form of deception that Satan has brought aloud us. And now, by the word of God, be free. May God cause you from now to run your race without any entanglement and any weight. Now, lay aside every weight in Christ.